What's up, everybody? Count Stankus back at you again today. And what a day it is with this magical box here, a magic box in front of me, which is a cool thing. But what a week it's been. I'm burnt out, tired, and thank God there was some light that came in this week and right at the end of the week, basically. I got this box right here from Big Bad Toy Store. And finally, my Wave 4 Mego figures finally arrived. And I get to bask in the glory like so many of you out there have already gotten your figures. I finally just got mine. I can't wait to check them out. I did not buy every single figure from the Wave 4, the Wave 4 Wave Mego put out. But the ones that I wanted, the ones that I really liked, and we'll see. There might be some more that I'll buy, because I decide for whatever reason I have to have them. These are the ones that I definitely have to have. There's no 14-inch figures in here, no, sorry guys. I don't even think anybody's gotten those yet. I haven't seen anybody get the 14-inch figures, so I think we're still waiting for those to show up to all the different toy retailers. But I got my Wave 4 figure from Big Bad Toy Store, and shipping for them, I've used them before for stuff, for pre-orders. I've only done it a few times. I believe it's four times total. This is the fourth, I believe. They're pretty slow, just to let you guys know. And the weird thing is, and it doesn't, it's no big deal, but I had people that who pre-ordered after I did, I mean, way after I did, and they already got theirs, and they live in the same state as I do. So that's okay. That's okay. It kind of was like, well, you know, not, didn't piss me off, but like whatever. I just, I don't know. I'm Big Bad Toy Store is odd. I'm looking at Cotsworld Collectibles as probably my next source to buy my Mego stuff from. I see a lot of people already been getting those figures from them. And I appreciate my good buddy MIB Master Toy Museum for turning me on to them. That's an awesome collectibles online store. I'm not sure if they actually have a store you can go up into, but you go on through their page. Down below is a link to their webpage to check them out. But maybe wherever they're at in state, maybe you can go and check out their stock in person to buy from them. But let's move on and let's open this box. You know, it's not a full-on review here, guys. I'm not gonna do that. Just gonna open the box. It's the first time I've ever seen anything from Wave 4. So I'm, well, not anything. Joe Namath I have. I do have Joe Namath. And actually, I'm gonna be getting tomorrow from a good friend of mine, the man himself, Muhammad Ali. So I'll be happy when I get Muhammad Ali. Very happy. So I'm a little behind. My targets around here don't have them. My friends around here that actually have found Joe Namath, Muhammad Ali. Did they find Joe Namath? No, I don't think they did. They found Muhammad Ali and the rest of the legends that they've got out from Mego. So anyway, let's bust this open right now. Let's see what I got real quick. It's fun opening boxes on videos. I love doing it. I haven't done it in a long time, but this is a special occasion. So. Luckily, the end of my week is turning out really cool, and I can't wait. I'm just praying to God now that everything is okay inside of here. I'm praying, so. My luck, something's damaged. That's okay, if something damaged, that's when we open, right? You guys know me, I don't really open up a whole lot of stuff. So if anything is damaged, I'll have to open it. I'll get a second one. So, got some bubble wrap on the inside of the box here, folks. So, cool. It's on the side of the box. Why not? We'll just, nah, I don't want it to fall out. So I was gonna see how I would pull out that way, but on the top, as usual, they have little things that give you, I've seen this a handful of times, a little promotion for Big Bad Toy Store. Yeah. And my receipt, you don't need to see that. Actually, their prices are good, and their shipping cost is actually very low. So maybe that explains why it takes so long. No, it doesn't explain why it takes so long. They get their stuff late. They really do. It takes them forever to get their shit. So that's okay. First up is, I can see already, is so far from the back, is himself, Nosferatu. I've only seen, I think, 2/3 of this movie. I've never watched the end of this movie. Probably because I fell asleep or something. Because, you know, it is a silent movie that he comes from. Oh, shit. That is so beautiful. I got number 1436, by the way, here. Sorry for cussing. Why am I apologizing? I do it all the whole time. Damn, this is so... Wow, I'm blown away. This is amazing figure right here. Hopefully it's not too much glare going on, but I'll do a closer video, and there's tons of videos out there, but I love this. The back of the car looks so cool. See his castle there. Talks about Marty as usual. This is a beautiful figure. Can't talk. I'm just really, really tired. The hell of a week, guys. But this is just too cool. This is awesome. I'm glad they decided to do this figure. This was a very good decision. So thank you, Marty and Joel and all of you guys. There's a lot of people to thank, but we'll get to them. We'll do a video about this guy here very, very soon. But this is fantastic. I'm super stoked. This is cool. So next up to bat, who's in here? Oh, he's speaking to me. Tell me, pull him out. He's facing at me. Let's check this out. Oh, the man himself. One of my inspirations on the guitar, Jimi Hendrix. Freaking smoking. This is 713 is the number on this Jimi Hendrix figure right here. And here's the back right over here, as you can see. And this is amazing. This is such an amazing figure. I hope that Mego, I hope you guys are watching this, because you got to do more Hendrix figures. There's so many more you can do. There's just way too many you can do in his different outfits that he did. This is awesome though. Hats off to you guys. This is really good. You guys did an excellent job on this figure. Looks really good. You know, and it's kind of funny, the hat reminds me of back in the good old days when the Indiana Jones figure came out, the 12-inch Indiana Jones Kenner figure came out. Everybody was upset about the hat because it was made of that felt material. And it just kind of was flimsy and floppily. And that looks like the hat here they had to do was kind of the same. So we probably, when you get out of the package, you have to mess with the hat to get it to sit right and everything. But, you know, Mego does what they have to do. He doesn't have to wear his hat, Jimi Hendrix. It's all good. This is cool. Card art again. Even with Nosferatu, this is freaking awesome. I'm no idea. You made my week. And next up, martial arts expert himself, Mr. Bruce Lee. Again, phenomenal artwork. I got 1,040 is my number down here. Damn, looks so sweet. Wow, that's an amazing likeness of him. Damn, that's just too cool. And the card art on the back. It's also really, really nice. Mego, you're killing me. You're killing everybody. This is amazing. I know that from the beginning when Mego first came out, myself, a lot of people, we were blown away looking at that card art, the rainbow thing with the stripes or whatever it was. Like, what the hell are we looking at? We're not going to go into that discussion, but there was reasons why that was done there with Target and everything. But, I mean, right here, we got right here. That was not the plan. This is the plan to do stuff like this. It's amazing card art and these amazing figures. You know, just so cool. Mego is killing us, and they got more stuff coming, guys. I'm not sure if you heard, they're gonna do some more musicians. Go online and check it out. They got some more musical groups that they're gonna do. Next up, we have the man himself from Nightmare on Elm Street, Freddy Krueger. This was a very good idea. Now, you know, I'm not a huge fan of the Nightmare on Elm Street. I love Halloween and I love Friday the 13th. This guy, I like the first two films, especially the first film. I think after that, it gets pretty kind of corny. And no offense to anybody out there who's a hardcore fan of this guy, but they get kind of dumb. Now, Halloween and Friday the 13th, those movies get kind of dumb, yes. But I think his movies got even kind of dumber. I'm sorry, but that's just my opinion. This guy right here is number 1638. And again, the card art is just phenomenal. Really, really nice. Really nice, and just amazing. Wow, there goes Tinkerbell flying around here somewhere. That's my phone. But in the back, you got a lovely portrait of the man himself. That's just too cool. This is awesome. And again, we'll do a little up close look on this guy one of these days here coming up. Phenomenal. Just, yeah, I got a little bit more to go. I'm getting more excited here because the ones down here are some of my, they're all my favorites. But yeah, let's do this. We got another version of the face of the screaming werewolf, looking a bit more like he did in the movie. Although his shirt, this is another, it's got black and white stripes kind of going on. No, black and blue rather, stripes going on his shirt. But in the movie he had more, it looked like more was a solid color, his shirt. But that's okay, he doesn't have to be exactly perfect, anything weird. But you do have the cool artwork that does come from the movie, which just looks, and again, This is awesome they did this. I'm glad they did it again. You got the Target version, you got this. Mego's known for its version they did over the years, so too cool. But we got 2126, that's our number. On the back, we got some more awesomeness. The face of the screaming werewolf. Yeah, so awesome, from Cheney Entertainment. So cool. on Chaney. That's the people who collect his money. Even though he's gone, his family, you know. So awesome. Too cool. All right, next, moving in to this box of wonders, we have the man himself, the Invisible Man, also known as Al Bundy. If you guys don't know the joke, Mego used the head sculpt for Al Bundy originally from the Target release, and they used him for the Invisible Man. So it's kind of funny. I would think that Al Bundy would love to be the Invisible Man if he could do that morph back and forth, which is so cool. Maybe back and forth, or not at all, just be invisible. But cool figure. And we got our very first clear, totally clear Mego figure. So that's awesome. I mean, if you wanted to, you could pop the head off and use the body for something else. Customize, right? You know, customizer probably already doing that. But love the card art. It's got a cool suit. This is number 2377. This is Invisible Man. We got the same art on the back. So this is great. Very good. So awesome. What a beautiful day. And I think I'm gonna save what I believe is my favorite for last. So we got two more figures to look at. Wow, we got Bela Lugosi back again as Dracula, this time Mego, and with some card art, looking very fantastic. And he's got his red lining on his cape, which from what we understand from the history of Universal, that the cape he wore in the movie Dracula had red lining as well. This one is 392. That's a pretty low number that I got. 392. Too cool. Does not have his medallion, his necklace. I'm wondering why they took it off. I don't know, but that's okay. So he looks too cool. I love the artwork on this one as well. He looks great. On the back, there's the man himself, Bela Lugosi again. Bela. Sorry, it's Bela. I believe that's the way you say it, but so many people say Bela. Phenomenal. Love this. Now, I love all these figures a lot. I think this is my favorite. He's staring at me. He's too cool. What an awesome idea to do a glow in the dark Frankenstein. This is the Frankenstein that we've already seen, that they did already. And obviously it's the Frankenstein that they used when MC Toys did their thing with Diamond Select. But this is a little bit head adjustment. We'll go to all that, but that's a review for another day. My number here is 26 of 26. And this is, again, a glow in the dark figure. The body glows in the dark, so is the head. We'll not get into that yet. We'll leave it for a review for another day. But card art, this right here is my favorite. I love Frankenstein, I do. I love all these guys. Probably Count Dracula is my favorite, but with this one, what you have here is a card that definitely is very reminiscent of the weird stuff that was done in the 70s. A lot of weird stuff came out in the 70s, a lot of weird figures, and this would fit right in with the look and glow in the dark on top of it. This is awesome. This is just awesome, and I can't wait to really gander at this guy and take a look at this guy. Look at the back, shall we? The back is pretty much similar to the card art that we got on the Target card, but that's okay. It's fine. It looks great. I love the front. I love the figure. And yeah, so there you have it, folks. There is, finally, I got my Wave 4 figures. I'm really super happy about that. And I'm gonna display them right now, and we'll get to videos very soon. I got a couple more videos coming for you guys. I wanna finish up doing the Planet of the Apes accessory figures, or accessory sets that they did. There's what, two or three left? I think three left. And then I'll get into these. I did do some custom figures. I'm not at all in any way, like there's a lot of you guys out there are huge customizers. I'm not even close to that. I can make some decent card art, and just slap together figure with different parts. So I did some custom Planet of the Apes figures from the cartoon from back in the day. I want to show you guys that. So that'll be down the pipe, down the road here. I would have already done it, but you know, things come up and I want to show you guys different things. But I can tell you that the next Tour Room of Insanity video that we have planned on with Lord of the Rings that my good buddy Matt Strange and I talked about, it is ready to go. We've had a lot of rain over here, so we need to do some things outside, and you know, and we need things to kind of like dry up, and then we can do the video, make it, and get it to you guys. It's going to be a fun video to make, and something I want to do for a very long time. I love Lord of the Rings, and I think this is going to be an awesome video. But anyway, guys, I can't wait for my new videos, and I hope you guys are looking forward to them. And if you haven't got your Mego figures, do it. You know, Big Bad Toy Store, they have them now, so if you order from them, it's not a pre-order, so you should get them pretty quickly, or just go to Cotswold Collectibles. Again, the link is down below. You guys can check it out there. But anyway, guys, I do appreciate you watching my video, guys. I really do. Down below is, again, you can find links for Instagram, my Facebook page, Count Stankus, and Twitter's there. I don't really go on Twitter, but if you put something there, I'll respond to you. I may not see it right away. It might take a day, maybe. You know, I'm not there all the time, but I do it. But that's it, folks. I appreciate your time. I appreciate checking me out, guys. And anyway, guys, don't stop collecting and have a great day.